Why does my laptop keep connecting to the wrong Wi-Fi network? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. It's actually a scenario that I ran into a while back, but here's the question. There are a lot of Wi-Fi networks visible where I am, but my laptop keeps connecting to the wrong one. I want it to connect to mine, not someone else's. Well, it's pretty easy to have happen for a variety of reasons. It is, in fact, Windows trying to be helpful by remembering the Wi-Fi connections that you've made in the past so that you don't have to select one over and over and over again every time you move to a new place. In this case, however, it's very likely you want Windows to forget one. I'll show you how. Let's go over to, this is actually my laptop. It is a Windows 11 machine. It's literally the laptop that I travel with where I ran into this problem. If I click on the network icon, you can see that it shows me which Wi-Fi network I'm connected to, along with some of the other networks that are available in this area. The list changes over time as signal strengths come and go due to weather or whatever. So this list is a list of the Wi-Fi connections that are available, not necessarily remembered by Windows. As soon as you connect to one, like for example, I've connected to my secured connection, once I specify a password and the connection is successful, Windows will remember it for you. If you want to select a different connection, you can simply pop up this same list here and select the other network that you wanted. So for example, if I wanted to connect to my guest network instead of my primary, I could just click on it and Windows would do whatever Windows does, connect to it, and would remember that it had been connected. Now, I'm not going to change the network here simply because I'm actually on a remote session to this machine, and doing so would disconnect me. Let's not do that. However, one of the things that you want to be able to do is forget the connections that your machine has remembered. That's actually not hard to do. What we're going to do is fire up the Settings app, and I'm going to search for Wi-Fi. You can see Wi-Fi settings comes right up. The thing we're looking for is this Manage Known Networks. This is the list of networks that this machine knows about. And you can see that I've got a list of actually a fair number of Wi-Fi networks that this machine has connected to in the past. This one, for example, is actually my home before I switched everything to a mesh network. Not only is this wireless network taking up space in this list, it's not something that this machine is ever going to see again. What we'll do is we will click on it, and there's the opportunity we want. We want to forget this network. Now, it will not try to look for this network, and it will not connect to this network if it ever does find it again. You can see here that I've actually connected to my guest network in the past. If I want to make sure not to connect to that network accidentally, again, since this is a live network, you can see that it's still showing up here as something that is accessible if I wanted to connect to it. If I don't want to connect to it by default or by accident without my interaction, again, just click on it, click on forget, and off it goes. There are a bunch of other networks here that I really don't necessarily need to remember anymore, so I'm just going to go ahead and forget all of them, to be honest. There is an argument that says, it's possible that wireless connections might happen a little bit faster if you have a short list of networks that have been remembered. My experience, not true. If there's a difference, it's minuscule. It's a very tiny difference. More importantly, this will do exactly what you're looking for. This will prevent you from accidentally connecting to a network you don't want to connect to. Ultimately, there's really no harm in letting Windows remember all those networks. But if you find yourself connecting to something you don't want to, or you just like a clean list, this is how you have that list cleaned up, by telling Windows to forget. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/145678. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.